Hi, do you think would it be possible to turn a sample perfume vial into a precision machinist level? Well, I've given it a try and had some interesting findings, as you will see later in the video. Spirit levels are made using curved vials, so that the bubble inside the vial will stay at the highest point of a semicircle, of which the tangent represents the line that is perpendicular to the direction of the Earth's gravitational force. The slope is given by the ratio between such line and the actual plane under test. It is, in other words, the rise over run ratio. So, to make it level, one should make a bended vial in the first place. Not an easy thing to do. Although vials can be purchased online, still I was curious to see if it was possible to make one at home. I also experimented capacitive sensors using a straightened sheet of metal from a tin can to make the plates of a liquid capacitor, arranged as two face-to-face combs, as you can see in this depiction. However, the capillary effect caused problems, and making the plates larger to reduce the capillary effect resulted in a smaller capacitance hampering the sensitivity. So, after having gave up the electronic way, I endeavored into the classic bubble, testing various options, including an acrylic tube cut to measure and small plastic tubes like ABS plastic reclaimed from pens. Using a plastic tube has the obvious advantage that can be easily bended with precision by placing a shim below the center of the vial and two shims on the top extreme sides, compressing them up to reach the desired curvature. This, however, came trickier than expected. The main problem that I experienced lies in the attraction the plastic exerts to the fluid. Despite using different liquids, including various solutions of water and alcohol and dishwashing soap as a surfactant, I experimented troubles in making the bubble to move along the vial with high enough sensitivity. For a sensitivity of something around 0.2 over 200 mm per division, these vials are fine, but for greater sensitivities they display some kind of hysteresis that makes accurate reading hard to be achieved. So the best material seems to be glass. And indeed, if I didn't mess up the math, the required curvature for the intended sensitivity, which is something in the 0.1 mm ballpark, it is just a few microns. So my idea was to either check the natural irregularity of the vial to exploit it, or to force and bend the vial. It turned out that these vials are pretty well made, with very little irregularities. This is an advantage, as the vial will be fairly accurate, but requires to force the vial. Well, you'll think glass don't like to be bended. Nevertheless, glass is somewhat flexible and should be possible to force a slight curvature. So, the first operation was to remove the sick print from the vial. This can be easy or hard, depending on the type of print made. I used a polished wheel with a polish cream that worked pretty well, but some prints are really hard to get rid of. Then I've built the case that will contain the vial out of one 15 by 3 and one 15 by 5 brass flat bars. The first one becomes the holder of the vial. Creating a square slot large 9 mm. And a 15 by 1 flat stainless steel that I glued below the slot with epoxy. The second one becomes the lid of the case. It sports a slot through which the vial will be visible. Below, a round pocket is engraved to make room for the top side of the vial. Then I made this trunnion with a thread stud. Through a 2mm hole, a steel pin clamped from a polished nail is inserted. And this pin allows the trunnion to pivot on one end of the case. The trunnion will be attached to the base of the level, and that will allow the case to be adjusted by tilting it up and down. Then, with a chunk from a wooden dowel beam and a 4mA screw, the knob is made. This will allow to adjust the tilt. The base of the level is made out of a 20 by 20 cold steel bar, long 200 mm. This steel part needs to be made flat, so after having roughly flattened down the bar on a flat stone covered with sandpaper, it then required fine work by scraping the bar to make it really flat against a surface plate. The case is finally assembled onto the base and the vial enclosed inside the case. A spring assures that the case stays pushed against the knob, and finally a series of marks spaced 4mm each are engraved on the top of the lid to have some references to read from. As I said, I ended up bending the vial. My first attempt, however, didn't went good because I needed to take practice. At first I tried to get a moderate sensitivity in a way that to move the bubble by one division, a shim of 0.05mm, 1.9 thousandths of inch, was required. To do this, I forced the vial to be bended too much, and during the night, you know, the temperature lowered, causing the spirit inside the vial to shrink, which in turn increased the tension to the point that the vial cracked. So I started over again with a new, shorter but larger vial. I adjusted the height of the case, gluing two brush wires, and put a shim below to get just a few microns in the order of 0.2 thousandths of inches, and giving a moderate pressure inside the case by carefully shimming the pocket that holds the vial to get a slight curvature. The result was enough. The level is fairly accurate, as it shows symmetry swapping the level by 180 degrees, and it shows a sensitivity of 0.01mm over 200mm, or 0.4 thousand over 7.9 inches, with a decent repeatability. So the final touch, I added two tappet holes at the sides of the base, and out of an 18 by 7mm piece of wood, I engraved the middle with a piece of some paper wrapped around a tube and then I used shellac dye to color it in red, and further transparent shellac to protect the wood. This created two nice handles that are screwed onto the sides of the base of the label. Not only these handles offer a better grip, but also help to thermally isolate the label from the heat coming from the hand. And this is the final product. Well, hope you enjoyed this video. If so, consider to click like and share it, because that is the only way I have to understand you like the video. As always, comments are welcome. So, thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.